pleasure to be here to recognize some of the city's true unsung heroes, the men and women of the DOT Roadway Repair and Maintenance Division who do extraordinary work for this city every day. I have to tell you, these are folks who work very, very hard, who have the pleasure of knowing that their work makes a very tangible impact on people's lives. You make people's lives better every day. You make people's lives safer. And the people who benefit don't necessarily get to meet you and say thank you. But we're here today to say thank you, because you've done something great for this city. Prepare for some amazing facts that will astound you. This effort to repave a huge swath of the FDR started in July and finishes tomorrow night. They've done all this in less than 6 months. And this crew and crews like them have literally done something that has never been done before. They approached the FDR as a single unit. They went at the whole thing simultaneously in less than 6 months. And what they did is extraordinary. Repaving 35 lane miles. Every one of those lanes out there, think about a whole mile in one lane. 35 lane miles, all in less than 6 months. That's never been attempted before in the history of this city. Certainly never been achieved before. These folks did it along with their colleagues, and for so many New Yorkers now, the drive around the city is better because of this extraordinary effort. 35 lane miles, would you like a visualization? It's as if you created a road from Co-op City in the Bronx to Tottenville in Staten Island. If you went that whole distance, a single road, that's how far what these folks did, that's how far it would be. And here's an even more remarkable fact. This project came in ahead of schedule and under budget. Let's give them a round of applause for that. Now, this was made possible by an investment of $7.1 million by the city, and we made this a priority. It's obviously one of our most intensely used highways, one of the gateways to the city for people from all over the world. Very, very important that this highway be made better for everyone. And this crew and other crews did it now. And the crew right here, part of an 85-member crew, together they have more than 1,000 years of experience. Don't feel old, everyone. It's okay. 1,000 years of experience that they brought this effort, which is why they were able to do it so quickly and so well. This is not easy work. Let me affirm it. It's not easy work. It's long hours. This started in the heat of summer. You can imagine what it's like doing the work now as it's starting to become winter. Doesn't matter if it's raining, doesn't matter how cold or hot, they're out there. And they have to worry all the time about the traffic moving past them, especially in the overnight hours when visibility is low. We are focused on the safety of the people who do this work. We want to make sure each and every one of them gets home to their families each day. So a very big part of what DOT does is ensuring the safety of the people make our roads better. And it's always important we send a message to drivers in this city. Whenever you see a work crew, slow down. When you see people working on the road, slow down. Remember, there are people who do a lot for all of us. They have families they need to get home to. We also help drivers to know when roads are going to be paved so they can make adjustments. There's paving updates provided to the media and to the public. And we make sure that any motorist who violates the rules in a work zone pays for it. We've increased the fine for motorists who speed in work zones, and we will aggressively enforce those laws. So, we're here today to talk about the very good work that this group has done. Necessary work, courageous work that makes the lives of hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers better every year. I just want to say something simple to folks here on behalf of almost 8.5 million New Yorkers. Thank you for the tremendous work you've done. Just to give you a sense of the magnitude, 150,000 drivers travel this road every day, and they all are feeling the difference of this work. And duration of that, that's as if DOT is resurfacing 2,500 lane miles all over city. That's as much distance as going from New York City to Las Vegas. That is how much they're doing in the next year and a half. We're investing $1.6 billion in city funds over the next decade to resurface roads all over the city. It goes without saying the money's important, but the people power is what matters the most. These good men and women who make the work happen every day. Just quickly in Spanish, tengo el honor de reconocer hoy a un grupo de héroes anónimos. Los trabajadores de la unidad de reparación de autopistas de nuestro departamento de transporte. Ellos han trabajado duro por meses para renovar todo el FTR Drive. Les damos gracias por esta gran labor que tendrá un impacto muy positivo en las vidas de todos los neoyorquinos. Y reafirmamos nuestro compromiso con mantener altos niveles de seguridad para todos los trabajadores viales. With that, the woman who leads the operation, and she does it with great energy, great focus. When Polly and I talked about making this happen, she knew it was a daunting task, but she brought a great can-do attitude to it. With all the leadership of DOT, they said they knew it would be tough, but they were going to get it done. And Polly, you were good to your word. Our Transportation Commissioner, Polly Trumper.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I couldn't be more proud, just like you, to be standing here today in front of our DOT roadway crew with some of our elected officials who are partners. Looking at it, it's really been a remarkable paving season that is actually going to make roads smoother and safer for millions of people. As you said, Mr. Mayor, resurfacing the FTR was no easy feat. We figured out it had at least been 50 years of effort that anyone had tried to resurface it comprehensively. It is one of the 10 busiest roadways in the city, as you pointed out, well over 150,000 vehicles a day traveling. It has many complexities, weight restrictions, height restrictions, mixture of city-state ownership. It took a lot of cooperation, coordination, and really good planning. And this amazing team and the leadership here helped make it happen. But none of it could have been possible without your leadership, Mr. Mayor. We certainly had many conversations about it. You provided the leadership, the support, and the resources. So we couldn't be more grateful to you as well. And the support you gave us, an additional $242 million to do 500 extra lane miles in the next 2 years, is going to be the highest amount of resurfacing the city has seen in 5 years. And just to mention a few of the other roads that the funds have helped us resurface, Fordham Road and East Compton Road in the Bronx, DOT
leadership in this city. We're not only we put the money, but also we the great men and women doing the work. They are delivering project on time and saving money. No, that's not an everyday using any major project at the state or city level. Usually projects are more expensive when they are completed. So here we are the great new, and New Yorkers should know that as we were able to put the money together with the great leadership with the mayor and the speaker today after Thanksgiving, the great news is that this project has been completed. And knowing that there's a lot of money there, there's millions of dollars also being invested with the great job of the men and women, the DOT, they will continue reversing into New York City. This is something that will help drivers, it will make the streets safer, it will improve the efficiency in our city. But most important also, we have the great men and women doing the work. And today the awareness that we are doing is of the educational awareness. It's to send a message to all the drivers citywide. Slow down. When there's any work zone with the men and women that work in the road, please slow down so that we can go home safe and also the workers can be safe. Para nosotros es muy importante saber que tenemos un liderazgo en esta ciudad que ha trabajado para asegurarse de que este proyecto se termine a tiempo y que ahorró dinero. Solamente posible con una líder en esta ciudad como es el alcalde de Blasio y la comisionada de DOT.
Especially when it's happening, but they prefer to see it at night. They prefer to get the notices, and DOT was amazing about letting the community know ahead of time. And anytime somebody said, oh, there was a loose plate or what have you, we're able to fix it for them usually that day. So when it comes down to it, DOT has been an amazing partner and has been fixing the FDR in the whole and in the small part every step of the way. So thank you to DOT and thank you to our workers.
On this topic, and then we'll go to off topic. On this topic, first, Michael. Well, you know, we had for a long time, I think many of us had heard complaints about the FDR. I certainly experienced it constantly, seeing how just wasn't an acceptable state of repair for the greatest city in the world. And, you know, as you heard, one of the very busiest highways in all of New York City. and one that is one of our gateways. And I think it was important to really put a focus on. So I think the conversation probably started late last year, if I remember correctly, and going into the budget process. I like to give Polly reports from where I am around the city of what I'm seeing, and I certainly call her when I hit the bump in the road. I tell her exactly where it is so she can follow up and call her from different places. But this has been one I think we had the most complaints about and the most concern about for a long time. On this topic, FTR, yeah. How's it? The flooding concerns, I mean, on the FDR?
Well, as I had mentioned, one of our partners in this project was the Department of Environmental Protection, and one of the things we did is we also fixed all the catch basins on the FDR drive that had not also been replaced, we think, for an equal number of decades.
Show yourself. Oh, I've certainly experienced it, but again, we've heard complaints about this one for a long, long time, and it's, again, for one of our very busiest roads, absolutely was well beyond the point that it needed a major overhaul. And I think that's what is part of this entire concept of this repainting program. We're going to go to the most important roads in each borough. As you heard Polly delineate them, the ones we've done this year, the ones we're doing next year. This is a very large-scale repainting program. And in the case of the FDR, an unprecedented one. Because it's one of the most important quality of life issues to New Yorkers. And, of course, it's a matter of safety as well. So this is exactly what government should be focused on. When I was out in Staten Island, on the South Shore with Polly a few months back, very different weather. This is one of the things people there said was one of their number one concerns. They had roads that were dangerous and constantly being jostled in their cars, and if government could do one thing, they would ask to repave the roads, right? So we're really focused on repaving and getting it right all over the city. Back.
Stay tuned on that.
Last call on FDR and repaving. that investigation will proceed promptly, and if we find any wrongdoing, there will be very serious consequences for the individual involved. The Renewal Schools effort is a major priority for us. We've put a lot of resources into it. What we're finding in Renewal Schools is increased attendance. We saw an improvement in test scores from the previous year to last. We see the beginnings of real turnaround, but it's going to take a lot of work. We said from the beginning this would be a very tough effort, but worth it. But anytime we see a problem, we're going to go right at it. If that requires investigation, we'll do it. There's an investigation. I don't know the details. But again, the Department of Education initiated that investigation. If we see anything that concerns us, we're going to look into it immediately. I would say it's two things at once. The toxic rhetoric is very bad for this country, and I think is unfair, doesn't represent the reality of Planned Parenthood, which is an extraordinary organization that this administration supports fully. I think the individual involved obviously is someone with real mental health problems, who committed an act of violence that was unacceptable by every measure. So I think we need to address the toxic environment because of what it means for policy, not because of an individual who did something horrendous. I think we need to address it because we have an attempt right now to undermine Planned Parenthood, and Planned Parenthood is necessary for the health and well-being of women all over this country. No, I don't have an update on that, but we'll get you later. Look, and when I was a city council, member. I work with community boards very closely, and obviously the borough board in Brooklyn. They provide important feedback. They provide perspective that helps us as we're shaping our plans. But everyone knows in this city, community boards are part of a much bigger process that includes the city council, city planning commission, mayor's office. So those advisory votes are meaningful, but they're not the final word. And we also know the community boards are often negatively, when it comes to anything that might be new developed in the community, often negatively disposed. That's not a news flash. We know that. What we're talking about is a different approach to development, and I don't blame people who haven't seen it before for having tough questions. But we're talking about demanding much more from developers, creating much more affordable housing than has ever been created before, protecting people in communities with legal services to stop eviction and harassment. It's a whole new approach, and of course they'll be doubting Thomas's at first, but I think over time we'll be able to show people it works. Okay, we're coming right here, Rich. New thing about Salt Ridge? Surely, Rich, there's another word you can use. There we go. I thought you'd become a millennial for a moment there. What about my salt usage? Is that what you're asking? I eat too much salt. I, too, have sinned, Rich. I have to say, in my ancestral cuisine, there's a lot of salt, and I was brought up with a lot of salt, and I, luckily, Charlene is very, very adamant about reducing the use of salt, so my hand has been slapped many times, I've been stared down, the salt shaker's been moved to the other side of the table. I'm on the pathway to becoming a better human being. More to that story than was originally reported from what we're hearing. I think there are other considerations that went into it. But the bottom line is, whenever there's a quality of life problem, we're going to go at it. That's the 4-8 precinct. They've been deeply involved with the merchants along Arthur Avenue, with the bid. I asked some very specific questions about that situation. It comes down to three homeless individuals along the Arthur Avenue strip who've been a problem. And they're known to the police, they're known to the Department of Homeless Services, and they're being addressed in a very forthright manner. Look, if it's one individual and he's not harassing people, being menacing or